up, y'all? So it's time for me to record. I have been doing a few shorts today, but I just wanted to come through and just go ahead and do a full video for y'all. Gotta get a cigarette. If you didn't know that I smoke, I do smoke, baby, and there will be marijuana smoked on this video. So if you are not subscribed to my channel, go ahead and subscribe to my channel, like my channel, and come on through and fuck with me. I'm gonna come back and start recording more, y'all. I just had to get my motivation back, and you know, with the shit that has been going on in America, good old America, I have not run out of content, and I ain't ran out of shit to talk about. So go ahead and like my channel and come on in here, y'all. Let's talk about Miss lying ass Carlee Russell and this accountability, this lack of accountability that black women tend to have. Let me give y'all a few seconds. Let me light my motherfucking square. I'm gonna light my square where y'all decide whether or not y'all want to motherfucking subscribe to me, and I hope you do. All right, now I hope that you all are subscribed to me, and if you're not, go ahead and keep watching. Go on, watch this video to the end and tell me what you think. So y'all, let's talk about Carlee Wilson. Why do I keep on the call this bitch Carlee Wilson? That's not that bitch name. Let's talk about Carlee Russell, y'all. This lying ass bitch, and let's pull some cards on this lying bitch. First and foremost. Excuse me. First and foremost, I want to say shout out to everybody who is like me and was like me and said that the bitch was lying from the inception of hearing this fucking story. Like, let's be realistic, y'all. How many times have you been driving down the highway? Those of you that are from LA, have you ever been driving down to 101 or down to 105 or down to 90? And you seen a motherfucking toddler walking its ass on the side of the interstate. How many times have y'all seen that? And as wild as LA is, I know ain't nobody never seen no shit like that. Those of y'all that's from St. Louis, what's up, family? What's up? What's up? Anyway, those of y'all that's from St. Louis, how many times you done seen a motherfucking baby on 270 just walking loosely? Or how about 170 or Highway 70? How about Highway 40? Have you ever seen a motherfucking baby walking around that motherfucker aimlessly, like outside at midnight or thereafter? It's dark as a motherfucker outside, and here's a fucking toddler. This is what Carlee alleges, and I'm going to read a few excerpts from a little bit of the stories that I've been keeping on this lying ass bitch. Who, first of all, I had when I first saw the story and saw her birthday, I thought she was a fucking Leo. I am so elated that I was wrong. Yo, I was like, when I thought she was a fucking Leo, because her birthday is July 22nd, I was like, damn, that Leo pride didn't kick in on this bitch yet. But I'm skipping ahead of myself on why I said that. But I'm so glad that bitch was born July 22nd, baby. That is such cancer behavior she just pulled. And cancers, I love y'all, but y'all some crazy motherfuckers, okay? Some silent crazy motherfuckers, okay? Anyway, this is what we're getting from Google as of today. That Leo cusp energy that she has, see, and I'm not advocating that we Leos are perfect. Yes, we are. Yes, we are. But I'm not advocating that Leos are perfect, but that Leo cusp on her with that July 22nd, that's dangerous than a motherfucker. She's got some of them lower, that low energy Leo shit going on, that lying and manipulating shit that us Leos do. Come on, Leos, we tell the truth, and we gotta, you know, tell the truth and shame the devil, or shame Miss Carlee, wherever the fuck I put her picture at, that's where I'm tilting my head. Shame Miss Carlee, shame up. Tell the truth and shame the devil, honey, because that Leo cusp that she's on, you know, she's dangerous. That type of person with that cusp energy is almost often very, very dangerous because you don't know which way to take them. You know, they are sneaky with Nine of Coins energy. That is the energy that Miss Carlee gave me all along. She Hold on, y'all. I'm sorry. She gave me that energy of sneakiness anyway. And you know, with the Nine of Pentacles, there comes sneakiness, secrets, you know, somebody that's laying in wait doing something. What was this stupid bitch doing? Had everybody thinking that she had been kidnapped, and she was sneakily laying back watching, laying back looking, being sneaky, calculating, biding her time, trying to see what it was that she was going to do if this story had taken, had gone the way it's going now. If things had gone left, if things had gone awry, what was she doing? This poor baby. It's always about a nigga. It's always, 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 always with you bitches about a motherfucking man. About a man that don't want you at that. There's always some story that comes out, or the underlying theme of you bitches being hurt, or you bitches being in your fucking feelings, you bitches operating in that King of Swords in reverse energy. It's always about a man. It's always some low energy shit that's going on, some evil foolish thought that you are having, some thought that's not clear, some thought that's moon in reverse. Let me put it like that. It's always some you should have thought this through situation that we always go through. With Carlee, as far as I know, it was a situation regarding a dude because he was cheating on her. And some reports are saying that he was about to break up with her, or he was about to go on with his side piece. See, it was trouble in paradise, or in the paradise that she claimed that existed. And it really, truly didn't. She was in a situation where she was trying to hold on to a man that had another bitch. You know, he had plenty of lovers. He was one of these type. He was one of those that, first of all, he was a single man. And I keep telling you women, when you are not married to that man is fair game. Y'all might as well cut the bullshit. Stop even expecting for these men to be 100% faithful to you, especially depending on the type of man. Now, let me say that before some of y'all come up out your wig and get your ass beat in these comments, because I'm going to start commenting back to you motherfuckers with the same energy you're giving. But he's one of those guys that had multiple lovers. And again, like I said, y'all might as well get it in your head that if you are not married to this man, he literally is fair game. Now it is up to that man to decide that he loves or cares about you enough to where that he won't entertain these other lovers. But that wasn't what Carlee Russell's boyfriend or her dick piece. I feel like this, if you're fucking with a man and he fuck with you like that, and you go in with him or whatever, it's your boyfriend. Let's just say it's your boyfriend, not your husband, because I'm not shitting on just boyfriend and girlfriend relationships. But if this is just your man or whatever, and he loves you enough, he's not going to cheat on you. He's not going to entertain other women. He's not going to do that. That wasn't the case in Miss Carlee Russell's lying-ass situation. This nigga had him another woman, and he probably was about to cut her loose, really. That's really what that Two of Swords is about, and this Two of Wands. He was trying to make the decision on how he was going to leave her the fuck alone. And that's where Carlee came up with this elaborate idea to decide to say that she was missing. I'll bet y'all, I'm willing to bet y'all, with the Six of Cups energy, or the Six of Cups being present, influenced by this moon card, I'm willing to bet y'all any money that she has a history of telling grandiose lies like this and doing things like this to gain attention or affection from men. That goes back to, where's my Four of Wands? Because I pulled that. Although this represents sometimes, you know, your home and all of that, this also represents familial environments. This goes back to, this is her father, okay? She probably sought a lot of attention from her dad, and her dad was emotionally unavailable for her. And I'm not blaming her parents at all. Although, these two stupid motherfuckers, if y'all don't get off this TV supporting y'all daughter with this damn lie, that's why she's doing that. But I guarantee y'all she has that history of this because she's searching for her father's affections. And that's what be wrong with a lot of you women. A lot of y'all are looking for your dad in these dudes. And when you don't find him, you oftentimes feel manipulated or mistreated, or you feel like he's done you wrong, when in actuality, this man is just who the fuck he is. So in Carlee Russell's case, this man having all of these women, or having this side chick that she needs to get him the fuck away from desperately. Y'all fucks me up desperately fighting over these single men instead of just moving the fuck on. And let me say this, maybe your mamas didn't teach you. Maybe you ain't got no real friends. Maybe your homegirls advocate for this stupid type of foolery. But if you were my friend, I tell you, nah, friend, this is some dumb shit you doing, okay? Don't pretend to be kidnapped. Don't do none of that shit for this nigga. And just for the record, on my channel, when I say nigga, I'm talking about all men, okay? Not just black men. But anyway, now she's embarrassed because he's out here doing whatever he's doing with his lovers. And again, like I said, it's always for a man or at the behest of a man for a lot of you bitches. So she decides she gonna get back at him. She gonna stop this. She gonna get his affections by any means necessary. And she is going to use and abuse anything or anyone that she can that can help her in this situation, or let me not say situation, that can help her perpetuate this goddamn lie that she was about to tell. She needed people to believe that she was missing. So Google shit. He motherfucking found out how much it would cost for Amber Alert and all of that type of stupid ass shit. See, she did her homework. She did her homework on what she needed, or she didn't do enough homework. Let me say this before some of y'all believe that this is a smart thing to do. Before some of y'all believe that, okay, well, we can do this too. No, don't do this, dumb bitches, okay? Because this is some stupid ass shit that she's done. So she decides to do her homework, and she's going to use anybody and any resources that she can to actualize this plan of being fake kidnapped so that she can get her nigga attention. That's all it was about her boyfriend's attention. And I'm going to get through her story because I want to talk about the lack of accountability amongst women my fucking color and why Carlee Russell felt like she could even pull some shit like this. But anyway, she using people, did her homework, decided to use and manipulate people because for a change. And I was proud of people for coming together and searching for a black woman, because you know the going theme amongst black women, and it's true, but it's becoming a crutch now a little bit. But the growing theme is that, you know, we are largely ignored because we are black women. So she decided to use her black woman. She used her woman card, y'all. She didn't even use the black card yet. She used the woman card to manipulate the situation. And while I am pro-woman, this is why I cannot be 100% rocking and riding behind none of you bitches, because I knew she was lying. I knew that this bitch was lying when I heard this fucking story. I knew that she was lying when stuff was being withheld from us. When nobody knew or could understand where the fuck this baby went to. Like, this baby disappeared. Like, information was being held back from us with that Four of Coins energy. And it's like more information is being held back from us. All of this had to do with her being hurt over a dude. So here people are out searching, and meanwhile, I'm on the internet responding to people saying it was given to Tawana Brawley energy. And if you are old enough, or if you about my age, I'll be 43 in about 10 days, whenever August 2nd is. If you about my age, and you grew up through the 80s and the early 90s, think about that Tawana Brawley case, y'all. And think about the lies she told, and compare and contrast this bitch's story with hers. And tell me y'all don't feel the same way. The moment that I heard that she was missing, Tawana Brawley came to mind. Not only that, of course, I'm going to pull cards and jump on my Ouija board. And Spirit said she was lying. Spirit told me she was alive. And when I would get online, I would tell people that. And they, oh, Miss Cleo said, da-da-da-da-da, and laughing and shit. Well, it looks like Miss Cleo wasn't lying, was she? Because that's exactly what she did. Manipulated and used y'all, and y'all got y'all ass out here Carlee, when it's other black women and black children fucking missing, and here's this raggedy asshole playing with people and got y'all out here searching for, and I guess y'all found the bitch because she turned up at home somehow. She showed up on this Eight of Cups in reverse situation. She wasn't taken after all. She returned back home, showed up at her motherfucking mama's house. And now her motherfucking mama is trying to put it like, oh, it's over. It's all over. We found her. It's dead and done. And y'all need to move on. No, we don't fucking need to move on. Because here's why. Black women, are we hurting or what's going on? Are we starved for attention? What the fuck is the problem? And then when we're called out on the bullshit, why is it that y'all find so many excuses for this shit? How dare you say that? What if she ain't lying? This bitch has been lying from the beginning of this story. And y'all still finding somewhere in y'all chest, oh, you know how this country is. This is what, you know how they treat black men and black women and da-da-da-da-da. Black folks ain't never believed, but y'all don't even include black men in this fucking tirade y'all run. Y'all just say, oh, black women be talking and telling the truth and, oh, femicide and da-da-da-da-da. And man, let me relight my blunt on camera. Fuck it. Kids ain't got no business on my fucking video. Bitches holler, oh, the femicide rate and this and that and black men are out here doing da-da-da-da-da. Did Carlee Wilson, Lord have mercy. Did Carlee Russell, did she or did she not do this because of another black woman? Did she or did she not think about the black people that would be concerned for her stupid ass well-being? Hell, did she even think about her Alpha Kappa Alpha sisters, her sorors, who were concerned about her punk ass? Ladies, this lack of accountability has to stop. She's lying, okay? She lied, just like Jussie Smollett lied, just like Tawana Brawley lied. Just like a lot of y'all are lying to yourselves when you are still standing in solidarity with this stupid bitch. Or any bitch that behaves like this. If you behave like this, you are a failure of a human being. There is no excuse to tell a lie at all to get a nigga's attention, baby. If he don't want you, he just don't want you. That's just that. You know, you can be as beautiful as you want to be. You can be built as beautiful as shapely, like I've seen some girls out here with some beautiful ass natural shape, and this nigga's this dog, you know. But at no point is it cool for you to decide to include everybody else in your bullshit nonsense by telling a huge lie. Now she had everybody thinking that she was missing. Now her family is sitting up saying this stupid shit. Oh, y'all said she was missing. She didn't say she was missing. What the bitch do? Take a trip? No, y'all didn't come together. Now, this is just how I'm interpreting the cards. I feel like, y'all, they was all in on this together, or there is some togetherness going on behind the scenes. Maybe this is her family trying to cover up for her telling this motherfucking lie, but they're all sitting at the table together discussing what they need to say regarding this bitch planning this fucked up or pretending that she was fucking kidnapped. Yes, she's hurt us black women. She's hurt us. She set us back. Okay, and if you are sitting up supporting this ignorant ass bitch in this shit saying, oh, this country this and this country that and black women are never believed, you need your ass kicked. Okay? Because not only do we now have additional Ten of Wands energy on us, baby, we carrying wands for bitches that don't even deserve it. There are innocent black women and black girls out here that are missing, that are now not going to be found or even thought about. Ten of Wands energy. Now they got to carry these wands for this lying ass bitch. But you bitches on this internet faking up for. You bitches standing in solidarity for a motherfucking liar. You bitches is finding a way to juxtapose the situation. This is not a victory at all, black women. This is a super L for us. It is a complete Six of Wands in reverse. a complete Six of Wands in reverse. See, we got Ten of Wands and Six of Wands reverse energy on us. Now we have to, it's fucked up, bitches. We shouldn't have to gain the trust of the public back. That's exactly what it's going to seem like. What if a black woman comes up missing today or tomorrow? People are going to automatically say, oh, she's lying. Or they're going to say, I hope she's lying. Because again, I hope she's not lying. Because the last bitch hurt our feelings or hurt black women's fucking credibility. Our credibility is hurt, black women. From all of the ass shaking and the showing the ass for no fucking reason and the overall tackhead ass behavior that women are displaying, and in abundance, black women. Because see, don't come to me talking about what these other women are doing. Don't give a fuck about what these bitches doing. Them ain't my sisters, you are. They skin color ain't the same color as mine. Yours is. They ain't my responsibility, so to speak. You are. Because first of all, you're the black woman, okay? I need to speak to you, sister. I don't care what they're doing. This overall tackhead behavior that black women have, enough, bitches. Enough. Supporting bullshit like this shit that this Carlee girl done put out here. Enough. Mothers who are like this, who support their children when they are wrong. Enough. Because you're fucking creating little narcissists. You're creating motherfuckers who see no consequences or see nothing wrong with telling lies and using people and playing with people's emotions. But your ass might be used to that shit because you sure go sit your ass up in church and listen to a pastor lie to you and don't say nothing. See, the more I pull on Carlee Russell, the more shit come out. It's like she pretended to be pregnant or she wanted to be pregnant. And that plan either didn't work for her or didn't get off the ground good. Or she lost the baby because she has Ten of Swords energy too. So maybe the dude's energy. Maybe he put her in a stressful situation. No doubt he did. And she lost the baby with the Ten of Swords showing up. But that's still no excuse for her to do the bullshit she did. This cusp-ass energy, this cusp-ass Leo energy she got with this Seven of Swords. There are two things going on here for her with this Seven of Swords energy. First of all, she's fucking lying. Okay? No matter what y'all think, no matter how y'all justified black women, this bitch is lying, okay? She's lying. Extend some of that fucking energy and that support towards these girls that are really fucking missing, okay? And don't limit it to just black girls that are missing. There are a lot of Native American girls missing, Mexican girls, Asian, Indian. Shit, girls all over the fucking world. Shit, I'm sure it's a white girl missing. A girl, white girl is missing for real. But if you want to keep it towards just black women that are missing and black girls or black children, then go put that energy towards some black children and black women that are missing for real. Stop being in support of bullshit and lies and then jumping on these motherfucking blog spots or these motherfucking making these videos condemning black men and talking this shit about how black women are just so abused and neglected when you won't even stand up and point out when your own sisters are wrong. Stop this shit, ladies. Stop this shit in general, women. That lack of accountability that we have, that, oh, we did no wrong. That damsel-ass motherfucking shit. Not damsel in distress, but that damsel attitude that you bitches have. Stop it. And I noticed that a lot of the bullshit comes from a lot of you hoes that call yourself soft girls. Baby, sit down. You're no more a soft girl than you are a motherfucking male. Sit your stupid ass down. If you are a soft girl, you don't have to announce it. It shows in your behavior. No, I'm not anti-soft girl. But I'm tired of you bitches with this too. I'm tired of it. You can't be a soft girl and a tackhead at the same time, lady. choose which side you're going to be on. Anyway, Carlee thinks that this situation is over, but it's far from not being over. There's a lot of shit that is going to come back and haunt her family, and it's going to open up a floodgate of maybe exposure of things that have gone on with her family, and she's going to be quite embarrassed. Nobody's believing her stories no more. This shit is over for her. She's going to be quite embarrassed, and she's going to be quite, they might as well get ready to be pariahs, because that's exactly what the fuck is getting ready to go on. They might need to go on and move, because, child, ain't nobody finna deal with this shit. They might have thought that maybe she can come from under this, and they're thinking maybe she can recover from this, but she is not. She's about to lose a whole lot of shit. It looks like her dad might stop supporting her, though. But her mama is going to support her in the long haul, y'all. Her mama is going to rock with her and ride with her on whatever the fuck lies that she tells. And we'll end up moving on from this story before her mama shuts her mouth or before they close their mouth. However, some of y'all are wondering if she is going to go to jail. Let's see if we can pull some cards and see if this bitch gonna go to jail. Is this bitch going to jail, y'all? Well, she's gonna try to be quiet about things, or maybe the media or her, or the situation isn't being totally exposed to us. There is some things that are not being spoken of. Her dad knows a lot, I will tell y'all that. Her dad and her mother know a lot. They're both coming up. And Carlee herself is showing up in the position of the Cancer, in the Queen of Cups position. Capricorn, this is not a shot at you, but she's giving off that lying energy, and she's going to stick to the story energy of the Capricorn as well. Not only is this her mother and father showing up, sticking with her, her father is going to stand by her, but he's going to close his mouth. That's what the energy I'm getting from him with the King of Cups. He knows shit, but he's going to take it to his grave. He's like, yeah, I know this bitch did this bullshit, but her mama is going to try to ride this out. I don't know whether she sees fame in this or she thinks that this is going to spin off into some other shit, but it's not, because Carlee is going to end up going to jail. And may they make an example out of her ass, too. Before y'all say, oh, she doesn't deserve to go to jail. Yes, she does. She wasted manpower and resources, not to mention she played a game. She committed a felony pretending to be taken, and she wasn't. Kidnapped, taken, whatever y'all want to call it. It's over for her. And all of this is over a man.